New York, WOR. John, welcome to the program.
Yes, I'll tell you, he was deserved to be fired, and he's sticking up for these people. All you bums, you working for the Tea Party, all of you.
Shut your mouth, you street bum, you. Who are you? Who the hell are you? Who listens to you? Who the hell would ever listen to you other than someone on talk radio? Who do you think you are? What have you done with your life, you nothing?
Again, trust me.
Who are you? Tell me who you are. Tell me what you do for a living, that you know anything. What do you know? What'd you go to the third grade?
Tiger, beat it a cat, you phony baloney.
What do? You sell drugs somewhere in Harlem? What do you do for a living?
I do better than you. Talk about you white.
Well, tell us what you do. You know what I do. Tell us what you do. You want to get down and dirty with me? Tell millions of people who you are and what you do.
You're a bum, the savage. You're a savage.
You know what, my friend? No one will ever hear of you again. You just had your 1 second of fame. Goodbye. Have a nice life. So there is one of the minions that Obama would like to make part of his private security force. And don't, by the way, forget for 1 minute what Obama said prior to finagling his way into office. Remember that Obama promised that one day he would replace the military with his own private military force that reports only to him. The last time this happened on a major scale was in Germany in the 1930s. When the Austrian Adolf Hitler created a loyal bodyguard elite group that reported only to him because he couldn't trust the army. The army didn't like Hitler. The regular army didn't like Hitler. The Wehrmacht was unreliable for Hitler. So he created his own group of thugs who became the most sadistic of all killers in Germany. Listen.
We cannot continue to rely only on our military in order to achieve the national security objectives that we've set. We've got to have a civilian national security force that's just as powerful, just as strong, just as well-funded.
Now, you see, if Obama should follow through on his plan to create a civilian national security force, his own SA, the only man in the military who could have led a rebellion against it would have been none other than General McChrystal. Do you understand what I just said to you? You don't understand that this man is 3 steps ahead of America. If you think this happened by accident, you are mistaken. The people who are running Obama are thinking 3 to 5 steps ahead of everything that you see going on. George Soros. You think the Gulf oil spill happened by accident? That Goldman Sachs sold their shares in BP a few days before the spill? That Halliburton was involved directly in some nefarious dealings right after the spill? You don't know any of this, do you? You don't know that Soros invested billions of dollars in a Brazilian energy company. You don't know that he wants to get his money, his pound of flesh, old Soros, specializes in pounds and pounds of flesh. You think that Obama became president because he's such a genius? You think he wasn't handpicked by these money managers? You think he wasn't picked by these money changers in the temple of democracy? And let me tell you something else. You've only seen the beginning of what's coming in this country. You have seen the most incompetent, thin-skinned man in the American presidency fire one of the great heroes of this war effort.